But here's what's exciting.
What's exciting?
Well, we are the Jersey radio station.
Right.
And one of the things that makes us so proud to be New Jersey is our fruits and vegetables. And that's why we celebrate Jersey Fresh. And that is why we have special guests in the studio today. And this is the first one. Let me interview him for a minute. Oh, I'm sorry.
You know what, Judy? That pepper would be more interesting than our guest because I tried to talk to him out in the lobby. Oh, my God.
Nothing, right?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Just like
nothing.
An eggplant. Sat there like an eggplant. No. Introduce yourself again.
My name is Doug Fisher, New Jersey Secretary of Agriculture. Great to be here on this Jersey Fresh Day.
We see you every year.
We see our department every year.
It seems like once a month.
No, but you've been here before.
I've been here before.
It seems like once a week.
Thank you. Well, that's good. That's good. I got a lot to promote, a lot to talk about.
You know, I love to give people that work for the government a hard time. So the closest I can, now the politicians won't talk to me anymore after screaming at them. Closest I get is the guy from the agriculture
department. How far the mighty fall, Dennis.
But I love Doug and the work that he does because it's a great part of our state. Now, Jersey Fresh is a program that the government has with pairs with farmers. And it was the first one of its kind in the country.
Right. It's pretty much modeled. So many other states model now on Jersey Fresh.
There you go.
It is the oldest program in the state.
33 years?
33 years. Jersey Fresh grading system, quality product, and people recognize Jersey
Fresh. So to get the Jersey Fresh stamp and label, it has to pass.
Right. There's quality grading standards, number one or better.
Yeah, so when you go to the grocery store and you see that Jersey Fresh symbol, it really means something.
Absolutely.
People look for it. And you're saying we export our products to even as far as Canada.
We do.
Other states like Pennsylvania, New York, Vermont, whatever?
Yes, right now we're sending blueberries. As you know, we're right in high in blueberry season. We're sending them into Canada.
And where people,
look for it. They look for Jersey Fresh.
Doug, I got to ask you, we always, the Jersey tomato, and that's all we talk about here, Jersey tomatoes. We go, you can't find a good tomato anywhere else, but if you had to say, besides a tomato, what is the second thing? Maybe it's not even the first thing. I don't know.
Blueberries. Blueberries. What else do we rate
high? What else do we rate high in? What are we most famous for?
We are most famous for cranberries. We're famous for blueberries. Right. We're famous for Jersey corn, Jersey tomatoes.
How does our corn stack against other corn?
Eggplant. What? How does our corn stack?
This too. Yeah. Peppers?
yes, no? Absolutely. Yeah, no, we're fourth in the country. We grow fourth amount of tonnage in the country of peppers.
Who knew? Did you know that?
Absolutely.
I did not.
She's holding a sweet pepper, but we have bell peppers,
frying
long
peppers.
Hots. Yeah.
Smells so good.
Frietels, my grandmother used to call them. But Doug, the corn. Grew up on Silver Queen Jersey corn. I had a variety.
What was that, Dennis? The one that we had from
Kentucky? I'm trying to ask Doug. Maybe he knows.
Okay.
About 3 weeks ago,
How's
we were
he
at...
gonna know?
How am I going to know?
Get out of the agriculture department.
Could I describe it? It was all yellow, and they were all in a line, the kernels.
Okay. Well, it was yellow with a couple of white kernels in there. And it was from Katona Farms in Chesterfield.
Great growers. We have that's bicolor corn, obviously, different parts of the state.
It had sugar
and butter, sugar.
We'll get you back. Okay. We'll get you back on the exact right. You know, there's lots of varieties of corn. Every farmer grows some special varieties
for
themselves.
But it's not,
that's true.
But it's not just the soil. It's not what is it? Why do we make such a good corn?
Well, first of all, we have great producers. We have some of the best farmers in the country.
That's
and
true.
You know, you don't just drop a seed in the ground and, it's corn.
I know.
It takes a lot of nurturing, a lot of common sense, and a lot of scientific know-how.
Might it be more difficult in this state because of other factors? Like in Iowa, you got plenty of room, plenty of space. Everybody's a farmer. Here, you may have more to deal with as a farmer.
Well, Iowa's growing feed corn. We're growing sweet corn. We do grow feed corn, but we grow a lot of sweet corn.
Yeah.
And people recognize it. You know, it goes right into New York. And by the way, when you grow something that's right there and the next day it's in the marketplace, that alone is something special.
That is true. We were at the farmer's market the other day and they brought us out some Jersey Fresh and we were so thrilled. Now,
That was in Judy's trunk before the 11 o'clock news.
Yeah, well, guess what? I'm glad I did that because this one I have absolutely no hold on. The second it came in the door, this basket of beautiful Jersey Fresh fruits and vegetables, they already said, you guys don't get this. We're grilling
them
today.
They're grilling everything out there.
Yeah.
You just told me.
Here's what I take.
Are they going to grill that baseball cap? Because I'll take it.
It might be a little tough.
You take the corn in the husk. You put it in a bucket of water for a half hour. Let it soak in. Put it on the grill. The water in the husk will steam it on the grill in the husk.
and then strip it down. Strip
Fantastic. It down. And Debbie here, who's sitting next to me, was saying something about the grilled peaches. I've never had it, but you always see it in gourmet magazines and stuff. So I think I'm going to try one of those today.
They say it caramelizes. The sugar comes out and it caramelizes the edges of it.
Yeah, sometimes when you have a steak, put on some fruits and vegetables and grill it at the same time.
Doug, you want our listeners to know that if you see the Jersey Fresh label on something, it is top quality and it's the best.
Absolutely, and people recognize that not only in just New Jersey, but all across New York, Pennsylvania.
You see it in supermarkets, you see it in farm stands, and you see it in restaurants as well.
Absolutely. There's great restaurateurs that are fashioning dishes with their with the amount of produce that we have. Because we grow 100 different varieties of produce in the state.
I didn't even know there were 100 different types of produce.
And for instance, peaches, out of that, just peaches, there's 100 varieties of peaches. That's why when you ask which one,
that's amazing.
What area of the state's the peach capital? Again, is that Hamilton?
Gloucester County is a big peach county.
Gloucester County, right?
Yeah. Wow.
Probably the only member of government that I love and would want to hug, Doug Fisher.
Well, we can do that later.
Come on, people.
Bye!
There's no hugging here. There's no hugging in baseball.
Farm people hug.
There is hugging in farming. That is very true.
Doug Fisher, you do a great job.
You do. And thank you for giving us something to really be proud of in New Jersey. We appreciate it. Yeah.
Thanks for having us on.
And thanks for the wonderful gifts.
And I'm, by the way, going to sneak some of this off the top. There's no way I'm giving this all to them to grill.
I agree. I would take it right now before.
There's a watermelon in the bottom, you know.
I know. That's mine.
Is it really?
Yeah. Got my name on
Sugar
it.
Sugar baby.
Awesome. All right.
Jersey Fresh, ladies and gentlemen.
Jersey
Look
Fresh.
For it.
You
buy it.
Stay around
eat
for
it,
our little barbecue.
Sure. Thank
got
you.
Booze. We got food. You're going to love it.
Our booze is Jersey Fresh. Many people don't know that.
Eric Scott still has a still in his backyard. He distills it in his backyard.
Sounds like I'm leaving.
Does the Agriculture Department regulate home stills?
We're getting more and more into breweries on farms.
That's amazing.
And our wineries.
You're involved in the wineries too?
Oh, absolutely.
You're not going to get into the marijuana business, are you?
No.
You never know.
You never know. No, they're not.
Medicinal purposes only.
Yeah. Right, of course.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you again for being here with us. I can't wait to dig in.